Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. We are going to make some tilapia. We are going to eat it with banko rice and everything. It goes with everything. It looks so delicious. Just look at this. Just sit back, relax, get some tilapia and all the spices you've got, and let's bake some tilapia.
Hey, welcome back family to my channel. Thank you for joining Jimmy, thank you for subscribing. Today we are going to make some tilapia and we are going to eat it with banku and mo and dokuno. Okay guys, so with my tilapia recipe we will need some tomatoes, some habanero peppers, ginger, garlic, some onions, and of course some tilapia. Okay guys, so I haven't left you guys. I already made two of my tilapia. I already dressed it, took everything out, and then washed it. I didn't leave you guys out. Okay, so I left one for you guys, so I'm going to show you how to dress it. And don't forget to put it under running water, it's easier. And then wash everything once you're done, okay? So, starting, you're going to cut the tail, cut all the fins or whatever. I forgot how we call this, you know, we used to learn it in, I think, JHS or SHS or whatever, like you learned this. Yeah, so cut it out. And then we are going to cut, I think it's called a fence or whatever. Okay, so use a good scissors, okay guys? My scissors is not that good. I think it's tired of me because I've been using it for about 2 years. Okay, and so we are going to cut this thing right here out. Okay. And we still have some here. So we are going to cut this out as well. Make sure you cut everything out. Okay, so this tilapia doesn't have scales. If it had, I would just use my knife to get it off, but this one doesn't. I think they already took it off or whatever. Okay, so next step is to open this out like this. Okay, make sure you don't cut yourself because sometimes it's really like sharp. Okay, I hope you can see this guys. So you know this, what you do, put it under running water so it's easier because it's really, see, okay, so you take this thing out. Take this out. And I always like to cut out this part too. I don't like it. If you like it, fine. I don't. And I like to cut this part out too. I don't like it. To cut this part out too. If you like it, keep it, but I don't like it. Okay, so then guys, you just take everything out, you put it under running water, and then you wash the inside and everything. Okay. Thank you. can see our, this is our pepper, tomatoes, ginger, garlic, and it's blended now. Our tilapia is all done. We are going to go ahead and put it in here. I blended a lot because I wanted to keep some in the freezer for later. So we are going to go ahead and put our salt.
Lovely friends, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. If you are new here, don't be a stranger, subscribe. Thank you so much for joining me. So with this tilapia, if it turns out to be a lot of liquid when you are baking, just drain out the liquid and use it for something else, like spicing up some tomatoes, grilling some green peppers and onions for your kenke or whatever you are eating your tilapia with. That's what I do. Anytime I get a lot of liquid out of the baked tilapia. Well, thank you. I hope you enjoyed this recipe and let me know how it goes. Ayas and the women. So bye guys.
Okay guys, so this is going to go into the oven at 350 degrees for about 40 minutes. I'll let you know the time it took for this particular meat to be cooked. I'm just doing it one at a time, so I will let you know how long it took, okay? See ya! Okay guys, our tilapia is all done. Look at how it looks, so yummy. Now let's garnish it and let's eat it with some bangku dokuno or some rice. Ooh.